From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
Welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Jim Keithley. One person is dead after an early morning shooting in Portland, and police are calling his death a homicide. Portland police were called to an apartment complex at 55 Allen Avenue around 3:40 Sunday morning after someone called 911 saying a man had been shot. When officers arrived, they found the victim, a 22-year-old man, originally from New York City, inside one of the apartments. Medics tried to treat him, but the man was pronounced dead at the scene. An autopsy is scheduled for Monday at the State Medical Examiner's Office in Augusta. Officers searched the area of the apartment for any suspects, but didn't find any. If you have any information about this case, you're asked to call Portland PD. The number there is 874-8539. Cumberland County Sheriff Mark Dion picked up the Democratic nomination Sunday for House District 113. Cumberland County Democrats held a caucus to choose their nominee. District 113, representing the North Deering area of Portland and the western part of Falmouth. After three terms as county sheriff, Dion says he decided to try and continue his public service, this time in the legislature.
When I was with the Portland Police Department, I worked on the budgets there at the municipal level. As sheriff, I've worked on budgets for 12 years. We've come in on budget. We've cut budgets. We have found efficiencies. We've cut out the waste. So I think my experience as an executive of a multi-million dollar organization, I think there's something I can contribute to the conversation in Augusta.
Current Representative Joan Cohen is not running for re-election and has already thrown her support behind Dion. He will run against Republican Charles Burns. The former transportation director for the city of Portland is taking a new job, chairing a national committee that provides advice to the Secretary of Homeland Security. Jeff Monroe of Cape Elizabeth will head up the 22-member committee, which addresses issues including security regulations and threat assessment policies. Monroe has more than 35 years' experience in the transportation and maritime industry, but Portland eliminated his position back in 2008. Farming has a long and storied history here in Maine. And Sunday, farmers all across the state welcomed visitors into their barns and fields to show them how their food gets made. Sunday was the 21st annual Open Farm Day, and farms in each county offered a range of activities such as milking, demonstrations, berry picking, and hay rides. News 8 joined visitors at Pineland Farms in New Gloucester for a tour of the grounds there.
It's a great opportunity for families to come out and kind of get a sense of where their food's coming from. Out here at Pineland, we have 200 head of Holstein cattle. Those are dairy cattle that produce milk. The milk goes over to our creamery, which produces cheese. And this year, we actually have a family farmyard. It's something new we're doing this year.
And part of the family farmyard, as you can see right here, includes those pigs, a big hit among the kids. Hundreds of people were already touring the farm at Pineland within the first couple of hours of Open Farm Day. A big success. We'd like to thank you for joining us here on News 8 Now. I'm Jim Keithley. Stay with us for the latest weather and sports highlights. We'll be right back.